Are electric vehicles green champions of the road or hidden culprits of environmental harm? Can they truly replace the roar of petrol engines without missing a beat? And is our infrastructure ready to support this electric revolution, or will it buckle under the pressure? In this video, we're plugging into the heart of these debates. We'll explore what happens when innovation meets the open road and whether the journey towards electric mobility will be as smooth as the ride in an EV itself. Join me as we navigate through the electric landscape, separating fact from fiction with solid evidence and expert insights. It's time to discover the real story behind electric vehicles. Let's roll out. Are we running out of critical minerals for electric vehicles? Let's charge into this claim and see what's really going on. While it's true that EVs use more critical minerals like lithium, cobalt, and rare earths than petrol cars, the idea that we're running out isn't right. Research shows that there are more than enough explored or prospective reserves globally to supply the energy transition, and in some surprising places. There's enough lithium, for example, in our oceans to meet future battery demands. And despite their name, rare earth elements aren't actually rare. The challenge isn't scarcity. It's about rapidly ramping up new mines and developing methods to use lower quality resources economically. But what if we hit a snag? Well, we can switch things up if needed. For instance, alternative battery chemistries like lithium ion phosphate batteries don't use cobalt. Sodium ion batteries could bypass the need for lithium in stationary applications. And guess what? We can make electric motors without rare earths. Tesla already planned to. Myth 2, EVs will end the weekend. Remember when our Prime Minister said EVs would end the weekend? Politicians don't say things that aren't true, do they? I wouldn't like to guess what ScoMo does on his weekends that owning an EV would put an end to, but it's not towing a boat or caravan, because EVs like the Ford F-150 Lightning prove that electric power doesn't mean weak towing capacity. This beast can tow up to 4.5 tons, more than enough for a boat or a caravan, and with 200 kilometers range while it's towing that. And it's not just about towing power. They're evolving into mobile power stations with vehicle-to-load capabilities. Imagine turning your camping trip into a glamping experience. Plus, the F-150 Lightning's operating costs are a quarter per kilometer compared to its petrol counterpart, making those weekend adventures more wallet-friendly. A downside for us Aussies, though, the F-150 Lightning isn't available here yet, partly due to previous political stances on EVs. However, the Australian market is catching up, with over 70 electric models available now, and more coming in 2024, including capable and versatile options for weekend adventures. Are you keen to check out the latest in EVs? Join me at Everything Electric Australia in Sydney this February 9, 10, and 11, where there are 13 EV models to test drive. Use my discount code EERosie for 20% off. Myth 3, EV batteries can't be recycled. People say EV batteries will end up in landfill. Let's recycle this myth and see what's real. This is my favorite myth, especially in combination with the myth that we're running out of critical minerals. So we're simultaneously not gonna have enough battery minerals, and we're just gonna chuck used batteries that contain those minerals into the tip. It's absurd to think that valuable, scarce minerals in batteries would be wasted like that. Recycling batteries is not just possible, it's happening. Companies like Northvolt and Redwood can reclaim over 95% of battery materials like nickel, cobalt, copper, aluminium, lithium, and graphite. But it's at a tiny scale. If the technology is already here, why aren't more batteries being recycled already? In fact, the main problem is that we don't have a lot of batteries at the end of their life yet. Assume that an average car will be used for 10 years. Going back a decade, only 700,000 EVs had ever been sold globally. This year alone, we're expecting sales 10 times that. So as more EVs reach end of life, recycling will ramp up. Some countries are moving faster on this than others, like China. In the first 5 months of 2023, they recycled 115,000 tons of batteries. That's about 250,000 cars worth, and more than they recycled in all of 2022. So they're scaling up fast. Myth 4, EVs will crash our power grids. Ever heard the myth that electric vehicles will crash our power grids? Let's plug into reality and debunk this. The way we're charging EVs in Australia is actually already smarter than you might think. Most EV charging doesn't happen during peak hours, as you might assume, like when everyone gets home from work. A significant number of EV owners are harnessing rooftop solar for daytime charging, aligning with solar peak production. This not only benefits the environment and reduces their costs, but it also gives all of that daytime solar somewhere to go and helps stabilize the grid. And another significant chunk of charging is done overnight. This helps balance the grid by soaking up excess capacity when there isn't much other demand to use it. And with advancements in grid management and renewable energy integration, the grid will continue to get smarter and greener. Looking further ahead, vehicle-to-grid or V2G technology will turn EVs into grid batteries, feeding electricity into the grid when demand is high. Imagine your car not just consuming energy, but also supplying it when needed. Check out these videos I made in the past if you want to find out more about how vehicle-to-grid works and see where it's up to in the real world. So, no, EVs won't crash the grid. They're key players in a smarter, cleaner future. Myth 5. Mining for battery minerals will destroy the environment. Have you seen claims that EVs need so much mining that they're worse than petrol cars? Let's dig beneath the surface to see the true story. It is true that an EV needs 6 times the minerals that a petrol car does, but that's just part of the equation. The main reason we're switching from internal combustion to electric vehicles isn't because of what they're made of, but because of what they avoid. Fossil fuels. Take a typical petrol car. Over its lifetime, it burns around 17,000 litres of petrol. In contrast, an EV's battery metals weigh about 160 kilos, 100 times less. And the vast majority of battery materials are recyclable. Even without recycling, EVs drastically reduce the need for mined materials. We're talking a 99% reduction compared to petrol cars. And of course, we know from the previous myth that EV batteries will be recycled, so it's more like a 99.9% reduction when you factor that in. There are extra greenhouse gas emissions for an EV relative to a petrol car that arise from mining and battery manufacture. So if you plan to buy a brand new car and then never drive it, a petrol car would be the more climate friendly option. But if you are planning to drive that car, the difference is made up in about 20,000 kilometers based on our current electricity grid's emissions. So after 1 or 2 years of average driving, that's less mining and less greenhouse gases for an EV compared to a petrol car. The shift to EVs isn't about choosing lesser evils. It's about making a transformative leap towards sustainability. And that's a wrap on my top 5 EV myths revealed. Have you heard an EV claim that you think sounded not quite right and you'd like debunked? Drop your thoughts and favorite myths in the comments below. I'm all ears and ready for a round 2. Don't forget, the electric exploration doesn't end here. Join me live at Everything Electric Australia in Sydney this February 9, 10 and 11. I'll be hosting an Ask the Experts EV myth-busting session on Friday, February 9th at Everything Electric Australia, where we'll dissect even more electric tales and truth. And here's a little extra spark. Use my discount code EERosie for 20% off your tickets. Everything Electric is not just an event, it's a chance to fuel our journey towards a cleaner, greener future together. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.